Hello and welcome. In this video, we'll show you how to convert your PowerPoint into a video by just using PowerPoint. There's no other software required. There are many reasons why you'd want to, including creating content for people to review after the presentation, and an easy way of making a photo slideshow video with no extra editing software. Keep watching and we'll show you how it's done. So, I've got my PowerPoint here, which contains a few slides with text that has animations, and a few slides after that that contain photos as a slideshow. I want to turn this into a video that I can give my delegates after my presentation. I want them to be able to review the video without the need for PowerPoint software that shows transitions and maybe has a voiceover. Now, there are a few ways of doing this. I'm going to firstly show you how to do this as a quick and easy way, and then at around 2 minutes 30, look at how we can actually record the presentation as we're reviewing it, with the added option of being able to give it a voiceover. Okay, so the quick and easy way. This will turn our presentation deck into a simple video. Go up to the top and click on File. Click on Save As. And then choose a location. I'm going to drop this back onto the desktop. In the Save As Type box, click the drop down and then either choose MPEG-4 video or Windows Media video. I'm going to select MPEG-4 and then click on Save. My PowerPoint will now be converted to video and saved on the desktop. This could take a bit of time depending on the size and content of your PowerPoint. You'll see the progress bar down here. Let's fast forward this until it's done. Okay, so here it is. Let's open it up and have a look. This is okay. This slide animations are maybe a bit quick, but for what I want it for, it's acceptable. And there you have it, a quick and easy way to convert a PowerPoint to a video. Now let's have a look at the method where we can record the video and set the timings where everything appears, and have the option of a voiceover. Okay, go up to the top and click on Slideshow, and then click on Record Slideshow. And pressing this button will start the recording. As I've chosen to record narrations, I'll describe what's going on here so we can hear it on playback. Okay, so here's my presentation. You can see my mouse movements, but they're not being recorded. Clicking will advance me through my presentation. Down here, you'll see the time spent on this slide and the total presentation time so far. Now, I'm going to click through the bullet points quickly and finish this off. Once you come to the end of the recording, it will appear that nothing has happened. But what you have done is recorded the timings in the background. Now, let's export the video with our timings and narration. Go up to the top left and click on File. And then down to Export. Go across and click on Create a Video. There's a couple of options here. One is the quality, which will affect the exported file size. I'm going to keep it on high quality. Under that, we've got the option to use the timings we've just recorded or not. And under that, we can preview what we've already recorded or record it again. I'm happy with what we've done and the timings, so I'm going to click on Create Video. I'm going to save this video on the desktop next to the original presentation and video we saved earlier. This could take a bit of time depending on the size and content of your PowerPoint. You'll see the progress bar down here. Let's fast forward until it's done. Okay, let's open up our new video and have a look. As I've chosen to record narrations, I'll describe what's going on here so we can hear it on playback. Okay, so here is my presentation. You can see my mouse movements, but they're not being recorded. Clicking will advance me through my presentation. Down here, you will see the time spent on this slide and the total presentation time so far. Now, I'm going to click through the bullet points quickly and finish this off. Okay, that's great. I've now got a video with custom timing and a narration. For teaching and learning, this would be great to give my students after the classroom session for reflection. Have a go at making your own video, either with or without custom timings or narration, and see how it works best for you. Also, let us know how you got on in the comments below, and if you found a better way to do it. Well, we've come to the end of this video. I really hope this has helped. If it has, please give us a thumbs up and let us know in the comments. If you're still a bit stuck, leave a comment below and we'll see if we can help you out. Please also hit the subscribe button to bookmark us so you can come back and be the first to hear about the next top tech tip. Bye-bye.